So we're doing circles. This is just a hint over what you're going to see in Algebra 2. So we have the equation of a circle right here, x squared plus y squared is radius squared. So if you don't have anything added, that means this is right here at the origin. That means you start out your circle at 0, 0. And the radius, you square the radius for that pretty equation. It's going to make more sense when we work one example right here, but it looks really complicated, but it's not. So, and then the general form, when it's not at the origin, you're going to have the h, and it was supposed to be k right here. The h and k. H is going side to side, or h will be x, or go with the x. And k will tell you that the circle is moving up and down. That means it's going to go with the y. You know, think about the y-axis going up and the y-axis, and then the x goes side to side. That is with the x. Anyways, I got one example right here. So we need to find the equation given that the center of the circle is at negative 2, 5, and they also gave us the radius. So following our formula right here, we need to find h, k, and r. Well, we don't have to find it, we have it. So like I said right here, h will go with the x, k will go with the y. So h right here is negative 2, k is right here with the 5, and the radius is given, so r is 10. All right. So we have our formula right here. So before I start doing anything, I want to copy the general formula. So x, now I'm going to substitute h with negative 2. So that'll be negative negative 2. Everybody knows two negatives make a positive. So plus 2. And then I'm going to continue on with the formula. And I'm going to substitute 5 right here with k. I mean, k with 5. So minus 5 squared. And then the radius is given right there, 10. And 10 squared is 100. If you're asking yourself where I got the 100 from, 10 squared is 100. If you don't believe me, type that in the calculator. And honestly, that's all the question wants you to do. Super easy, stop right there. The other example, now we have the graph. Now we need to come up with the equation given the graph. So the first thing we need to know, we need to find where the center of the circle is. So if I trace a line right here, top to bottom, and side to side, I know the center will be right here in the middle, right there. So most of you can just eyeball it and go, oh, right here at negative 4, negative 5. So center of the circle is right at negative 4, negative 5. So like we did in the other problem, we need to find h, k, and r. H right here is easy because that's the x, so negative 4. K right here, negative 5. Radius is the distance from the center to the edge of the circle right here, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Radius, 4. Piece of cake. Now copy down the general formula. Now we substitute everything. H, right here, negative 4. Two negatives make a positive. Be careful with this one. Two negatives make a positive. K, negative 5. So minus negative 5. Two negatives make a positive. So plus 5 squared. Radius squared, 4. Squared, 16. If you don't believe me, type that in the calculator. That's all you're doing. Piece of cake. Now, the assignment will be in Algebra 2. I excel will be U1, U2, U3, U7. All of them from Algebra 2, that's a U, not a V. You're going to feel smart after you do that.